Hachette Audio presents The Problem with Men, When is it International Men's Day and Why it Matters? By Richard Herring and read by the author with Alistair Green and Deborah Francis White. Alistair Green will be reading out some of the actual tweets that I've discovered on International Women's Day over the years. And Deborah Francis White and I will be having a long conversation about feminism and some of the issues in the book after the audiobook is finished. There is also other bonus material, including a stand-up routine I did on the subject from the show Lord of the Dance Settee, available at gofasterstripe.com if you want to see the whole show. Now let's sit back, relax, and enjoy The Problem with Men by Richard Herring. For Katie, Phoebe, and Ernie, for helping me to be a better man. Still some way to go, I'd say. Introduction. When's International Men's Day? I don't remember which year I first saw this question raised on Twitter, but I can tell you the date. It was March the 8th. I know that because March the 8th is International Women's Day. You might be wondering why anyone would ask that question on, according to the International Women's Day website, a global day celebrating the social, economic, cultural, and political achievements of women. The day also marks a call to action for accelerating women's equality. It's surely not unreasonable to set aside 24 hours out of the 8,760 annually available to celebrate slightly more than 50% of the world's population. Let's be generous and say that the people asking when's International Men's Day on International Women's Day are attempting to make some kind of a joke. It's a clever and subtle one, though, so I feel I'll have to walk you through it. In just four words, as Polonius says in Hamlet, brevity is the soul of wit. That's six words, Shakespeare, so they're funnier than you by your own standards. They're pointing out that even though International Women's Day supposedly promotes equality, there is, presumably, no equivalent for men. That's not very balanced, is it? It's a bit sexist when you think about it. On top of that is the inference there could never be a day to venerate men due to political correctness gone mad. It wouldn't even be allowed, because men are the underclass in today's topsy-turvy world. It is, you have to admit, a brilliant and concise piece of social satire worthy of Jonathan Swift, if it weren't for one tiny thing. There is an International Men's Day. It's on November the 19th. Still, you have to admire the confidence that allows someone to fire the fated question out into the world without even pausing to check Google, you know, just to ensure that they don't end up looking like an idiot. Initially, I found this amusing for its own sake, like you would a clown swinging to hit someone with a custard pie, but missing and hitting themselves in the face. On top of this, though, I noticed that if you were foolish enough to search for the phrase International Men's Day on Twitter, you would find thousands of people moved to make the exact same joke, all thinking they're making some insightful and original point. Not one of them was insecure enough to check out if it was an interesting or unique thought, let alone whether the basic assumption behind the question held true. You have to understand that this was the early 2010s, when we had no idea that confident idiots with no regard for facts would soon be running the world. So we could laugh, rather than crawl under a table and try to crush our brains in with a potato masher. In hindsight, we should have spotted the greater implications for humanity. This simple enough question contained the kernel of truth about the oversensitive, butthurt babies who were soon to have far too much control in the world. This was page one of their one-page playbook. Deflect criticism by flipping the narrative to manufacture injustice. If only we'd paid attention and spotted it sooner. I will admit that when I started noticing the When's International Men's Day trope, I was no fan of the idea of an International Men's Day. It seemed to me like a knee-jerk reaction to International Women's Day designed solely to undermine it. To my mind, it made the men complaining about it look a bit pathetic. Not just because there actually was a day already, it's on November the 19th, but also because it was such a babyish way to behave. Equally though, in that moment, I wasn't really thinking about politics or feminism or the crisis in masculinity. I just thought it might be funny to spend International When's International Men's Day Day, as I began to view it, searching Twitter for everyone who asked this question and politely telling them the answer. November the 19th. I did this partly to see how they responded, partly to show everyone else how ubiquitous this inappropriate, on this one day, question was, and partly in the hope that if I let everyone know, then maybe no one would ask the question ever again. Of course, by doing this, I was setting up an even bigger joke, an even more custody custard pie that was destined for my own face. That pie would swing and hit me every few seconds for 24 hours on an annual basis for almost a decade. I'd willingly made myself into a modern-day King Canut. That's the correct original spelling, C-N-U-T, of the name of the monarch, who is erroneously and much less amusingly more often known as Canute. I thought I had the power to turn back the waves of idiots in my case, but like him, I would end up drenched in stupidity in my case. My 24-hour self-employment as a twat-seeking search engine would leave me overwhelmed, delirious, and by around about 6 p.m. on the day in question, lead to me losing all semblance of politeness or chivalry. Was this social media breakdown merely for comic effect, or was it genuine? Even I wasn't sure. My replies became more befuddled, unreasonable, and insane. It was fun for people to spectate. It was not fun to be at the centre of this hurricane of twats. It proved amusing to most. A few were irritated by the relentlessness and unfollowed or muted me. Pretty quickly, I upset some Meninists who thought I was undermining the importance of their day, which they said wasn't a knee-jerk reaction to women having a day and actually dealt with important issues like male depression and suicide. And I also annoyed some feminists who thought I was making International Women's Day about myself, a man. I have some sympathy with both criticisms, and at least I achieved the impossible and united the Meninists and feminists, even if it was in hatred of me. I wasn't trying to be irksome, but those who were affronted or bored generally failed to recognise the joke was on me. It was a car crash of tedium and self-owned petard hoisting, although I'd hoped that some at least could admire my patience and resilience. It took me 6 years to realise that maybe people would make a donation to charity in return for my dogged and ridiculous dedication. A sort of sponsored trolling, even if arguably I was trolling trolls. But a troll troller is still a troll. Or a troll. I don't know how to say it either. In 2017, I encouraged my Twitter followers to spur me on by giving money to Refuge, a fantastic enterprise that helps women, children, and men who live in fear of violence. The response was beyond my wildest dreams. Donations flooded in. I was raising thousands of pounds an hour. I had invented a philosopher's stone that turned idiocy, both the questioner's and my own, into gold. In the end, I would take on this impossible challenge for 9 consecutive International Women's Days. Like Sam Beckett in Quantum Leap, though it could equally have been something created by the guy who wrote Waiting for Godot, I hoped that every completed year would be my leap home. This turned out to be a mission that could not be completed. The mental strain was becoming too much, but I was also forced to acknowledge what I'd really known from the start. This task was too big for Twitter. The issues that fueled the anger and resentment behind the question and its responses were bigger than the answer to this one question that no one actually wanted the answer to. I wondered if I could do better if I allowed myself more than 280 characters and asked more than one question. Maybe more important than knowing when International Men's Day is, it's on November the 19th, is asking, is International Men's Day something worth celebrating? If so, what should it be about? And how could the world be convinced to join in? What does it even mean to be a man in the 21st century? And who is it to blame for the few bad cards we've been dealt? Are women the enemies of the male sex, or are friends, lovers, and allies? If we want equality, why does feminism, which promises exactly that, scare and infuriate so many men? I'll attempt to answer 19 novel questions. Look, many of them aren't novel, but saying 19 pertinent questions doesn't cleverly reveal the date of International Men's Day, 19 November. Do you see what I did there? My editor didn't. Hence this over-explained explanation footnote that I'm doing right now. Sorry about that. 19 novel. Oh God, it's like the 19th of November. So I'll attempt to answer 19 novel questions in the hope that I can finally achieve my dream and stop anyone ever asking when's International Men's Day, even if it's just that one day of the year when it's invariably and inappropriately asked. Or maybe I'll fail again and just prove what everyone assumed from the start, that I'm a massive canut. All the tweets you're going to hear in this audiobook are ones that I've genuinely received over the years. We won't name the people who've given the tweets, as I think they've suffered enough, but their tweets will be read by the fabulous voice actor, Alistair Green, and I will read my replies.
When is it International Men's Day? Or am I once again being positively discriminated against?
It's November the 19th.
When is it International Men's Day? It's not easy being a man, awaits derisory laughter from women.
It's on November the 19th.
Pretty sexist how there's no International Men's Day. Aha!
It's on November the 19th. Aha.
So, when's International Men's Day? Will there be a parade?
It's on November the 19th. Plenty of time to organise a parade.
Does International Men's Day exist? Bet we'd get moaned at for pushing that.
It does. You wouldn't. It's November the 19th.
Is there an International Men's Day?
Yes. It's November the 19th.
Thanks.
No need to thank me. I'm just doing my job. I'm like a superhero, and my powers are knowing when International Men's Day is and telling people who don't know. It's November the 19th. Chapter 1. What's wrong with asking when International Men's Day is on International Women's Day? Everything! Everything's wrong with it! It's ignorant, it's impolite, it's inappropriate, and worst of all, it just makes the person posing the question look like a lazy and possibly misogynist idiot. And not just because there is an International Men's Day and it's on November the 19th. When people do this, they're trying to steal focus from something that's not about them in order to make it about themselves. And yes, we'll get on to the glaring hypocrisy of me saying that soon enough. Asking the aforementioned question on International Women's Day is blatantly self-centered and babyish, manufacturing outrage from a position of superiority. It's the same impulse that makes children question having two separate days set aside every year to celebrate mothers and fathers by asking, when will there be a Children's Day? Though at least children have the excuse of being children, and thus naturally self-obsessed and unable to spot that the world pretty much revolves around them already. Delightfully, and to keep this analogy spot on, there is also an International Children's Day. It's on June the 1st and is dedicated to all those children worldwide living in terrible circumstances. That won't assuage your complaining spawn, of course, because like the grown-up children questioning International Women's Day, they're actually asking, when's my day? When will someone make me breakfast and let me put my feet up and watch the telly? When will that happen? You know, apart from every single fucking day. Asking when's International Men's Day on International Women's Day is like going to somebody else's birthday party and instead of bringing them a present and singing happy birthday, smashing up all their gifts with a baseball bat and shouting, when is it my birthday? Why aren't I getting presents? Why doesn't anyone care about me? When I was 6, I went to my next door neighbour Claire Allen's birthday party. Hi Claire, if you're listening. Seems unlikely. Long time no see. And we played Pass the Parcel, and somehow, and I still suspect some kind of scam, given that Claire's mum was operating the music, Claire won and got the bag of sweets in the middle, and I lost my shit. I wouldn't calm down about the unfairness of it until Mrs. Allen gave me a mini Mars bar. I'd made a valid point about the injustice of no one celebrating my birthday at this party just because it wasn't my birthday, and I ate my sweet confection of victory. But was there anyone at that party who didn't conclude I was a total dick? Was anyone thinking, oh, I can't wait till Richard's birthday comes along and we can really celebrate what a fine fellow he is? Or did it make them less likely to show enthusiasm or show up on July the 12th, which is my birthday, by the way, if you do feel like giving me presents. Mark it in your diary, though unbelievably the UN have declared it Malala Day. When's it Richard Herring's Day? That's what I want to know. Maybe you're thinking, come on. The International Men's Day question's just a joke. We've all had enough of these sanctimonious social justice warriors who ruin our lives telling us what we're meant to think and want to stop us having fun. Let's wind them up and see how cross we can make them. I get it. I've often attempted to wind those people up too. I'm a comedian. Mischief is my job. But comedy is a serious business, and you have to make sure your prank is solid or the comedy bomb can explode in your own face. If I went on stage on International Women's Day and said, so, when's International Men's Day? Someone would heckle, it's November the 19th. And I would have no response, and the audience would sense my weakness, and the night would be lost. Because this is not a good joke. It ceases to work because there is a day on November the 19th. Some feel that they're righteously pointing out liberal hypocrisy. If women want an equal world, then surely it's wrong that they have a day and men don't. That's not equal.
This argument falters somewhat because, and forgive me if I've pointed this out already, there is an International Men's Day and it's on November the 19th. But even if there wasn't, that's not how equality works. We have an International Women's Day to acknowledge the ways that society is unequal and to attempt to address that. I can't tell you the number of times that women have wearily tweeted their own answer to the question, when's International Men's Day? It's every other day of the year. That's factually inaccurate. The actual answer is November the 19th. Asking when's International Men's Day on International Women's Day is like asking when's White History Month during Black History Month. For more on that, listen to chapter 16. It's like waking up on the 18th of October and finding out it's Anti-Slavery Day and asking, when's it Pro-Slavery Day? When do we have a day to look at things from the slave owner's point of view? Or is that not politically correct? Hashtag equality. It's like waiting for World AIDS Day to come along on December the 1st and tweeting, I don't have AIDS. Why isn't there a non-AIDS day? When will there be a day for me? It's true that men suffer from inequality in certain areas. That's one of the reasons we have an International Men's Day. It's on November the 19th. So you can talk about them then. If you genuinely care about that day, and we'll talk later about whether any of the people asking the question really do, then it's counterproductive to bring it up on March the 8th. Talking about men's issues on International Women's Day isn't going to make people sympathetic. Quite the opposite, because you're acting like 6-year-old Richard Herring throwing a tantrum about not winning some jelly babies at someone else's party. If you behave like a dick on everyone else's birthday, then it shouldn't surprise you if they're not that interested in celebrating yours.
Yeah, but you wouldn't have an International Man's Day because that would be sexist and discriminatory.
Apart from the one on November the 19th.
Hang on, when the fuck is it International Man's Day?
Fucking November the fucking 19th.
Imagine the uproar if there was an International Men's Day.
There would be, and is in fact none. It's November the 19th.
Is there International Men's Day? If not, I call sexism.
There is. It's November the 19th. So no sexism in the world at all. Phew.
International Women's Day today, I hear. Bet my right cock that there isn't International Men's Day at all.
You've lost your right cock. It's November the 19th. Hold on tight to the left one.
When is it International Men's Day? I forget.
It's November the 19th. Maybe write it down so you'll remember. Chapter 2. Is it definitely sexist to ask about International Men's Day on International Women's Day? Oh, God, no! Of course not. Not everyone who goes on about International Men's Day on International Women's Day is sexist. It might be true that everyone who's sexist goes on about International Men's Day on International Women's Day, but there are lots of other reasons to do it too. Loads. I wish I'd been given a longer book so I could list them all. Let's just do one. Hold on, I've got it. Some people just enjoy being willfully contrary. I know that I don't. They believe absolutely in freedom of speech and the right to say the things that are unsayable, even when literally thousands of people are already saying them. So many that it's not actually physically possible to respond to all of them, even if you set a whole day aside and do nothing else. We need these heroic and noble contrarians to keep society on its tracks, to relentlessly contradict the opinions of experts or anyone who's bothered to think about stuff for a second and champion neglected and redundant causes. It doesn't matter if they're causes that no one could possibly care about. All that matters is that the unsayable is said, even if the unsayable is stupid and upsets people for no real reason. This is part of a greater freedom. The right to be a fucking wazzock, the greatest of the human rights, along with the right to bear arms and the right to freedom of speech, as long as you're not forced to listen to anyone's replies. It's not about political correctness or sexism. Wazzocks just want balance to the universe, yin and yang. I'm aware it's yin and yang, but alas, the wazzocks are not. I'm with them all the way, and also fully oppose them. It's the wazzock way. However, I believe none of them are doing it thoroughly enough. They're only being partially contrary. If they're all about being opposite, then they should be tweeting International Women's Day, when's National Men's Night? It must be annoying for the wazzocks that some of their work fearlessly stating the opposite means they occasionally get lumped together with people who enjoy spouting sexist and racist nonsense. People only notice the Wazzocks tweeting about International Men's Day or White History Month and make terrible assumptions based solely on the awful character of everyone else asking those questions. They don't check the rest of the Wazzocks Twitter feed to see them writing, Christmas Day? Why don't we celebrate Satan's birthday? Double standards. Easter? What about Wester? Or wouldn't that be allowed? Groundhog Day? When do we get Sky Share Day? Every dog has its day? When will every cat get its day? That's Catist. International Cats Day is August the 8th. Bath Night? When's Toilet Day? World Toilet Day is on November the 19th. Darren Day? Where's Sharon Day? These Wazzocks, who dare to rise above the parapet to proclaim unwise and unpopular opinions for no reason other than they think they should, are the most oppressed minority in the modern world. I've been one of their main oppressors, and that's why I feel so guilty. Which is why I'm proposing making March the 9th, which is International Women's Boxing Day, if you will, International Wazzocks Day, a day set aside for all the men who ask when's International Men's Day on International Women's Day. For that one day, they're allowed to ask when's International Men's Day, and no one is allowed to mock them or call them stupid or point out that there is an International Men's Day and it's on November the 19th. In fact, on that day, everyone has to search for their tweets and reply, yeah, good point. There'd never be one, would there, due to political correctness gone mad? You're the only person who's ever noticed that. You are a genius. They won't appreciate it, though. They'll just reply, International Wazzocks Day? When's International Non-Wazzocks Day? There wouldn't be one, because of political correctness towards Wazzocks. Bad luck. I've already thought about that. It's March the 10th. I knew they would say that, so I made it the very next day. I'm always one step ahead of the Wazzocks. I work out what the Wazzocks will say, and I come up with an answer. I'm ready for them. It's like a game of chess between me and the Wazzocks. There are only two possible moves, and I make sure I'm one move ahead. It's pretty easy, because they just say the opposite of what you just said, so you can anticipate that. So the Wazzocks may come.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.